This famous sports figure, an all-time great in his sport, will be the subject of the bonus biography round this week on The Sports Challenge. Competing today, last week's winners, the champion Boston Celtics. First, the most valuable player ever in the NBA, player coach Bill Russell. The most successful coach in pro basketball history, Arnold Red Auerbach. Pro, the Celtics leader on the court, John Havlicek. The challengers are three distinguished senators from Washington. The first pitcher since 1931 to win 31 games in a season, Denny McLain. The great Hall of Fame outfielder, 400 hitter and manager of the Senators, Ted Williams. One of the great sluggers of modern baseball and the most powerful hitter in the game, Frank Howard. Sports Challenge, the award-winning play-by-play voice of the Rams and the Angels, Dick Enberg.
Thank you, Johnny Gilbert. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Sports Challenge. Our champions, the Boston Celtics, and they'll meet the challenge of the Washington Senators. The Senators, Frank Howard, Ted Williams, and Denny McLain. And Ted, last week on Sports Challenge, I don't know if you saw the show, we had your 1941 home run in the All-Star game that won it in the bottom of the ninth inning. I think I read somewhere once that you said that that was one of two home runs that you remember most fondly.
Well, I certainly have to remember that one because that was the biggest thrill I ever got out of baseball. And I'd have to remember the last one I hit because that was a pretty special one, too.
The only way a champion should go out, he hit a home run his last game with the Boston Red Sox. Those are the Senators, and our team that won last week over the California Angels, John Havlicek, Red Auerbach, and Bill Russell. John, as an all-around high school sports star, I know that you were drafted also by football clubs, pro football clubs, and we've been amazed at your tremendous endurance. It seems in that fourth and final period where the rest of the guys are trying to grab some breath, you're going fast as the ball. How come?
Well, Russell used to say I was crazy, but I think it's just a matter of mental preparation, and I think that you can overcome physical tiredness if you get yourself prepared mentally. Plus, I believe God-given ability has a lot to do with it.
Great to have you guys back. Boston Celtics and the Washington Senators, and each team is competing for $1,000 worth of AMF Voight sports equipment. The runners-up play for $500 worth. Johnny, for what youth groups are today's teams playing?
Well, this week the Celtics are playing for the Garrison Beach Teen Organization of Brooklyn, New York. And the Washington Senators represent the Lieutenant Joseph P. Kennedy Institute of Washington, D.C. Voight has been a leader in sporting goods for 50 years. All sports from basketball to bowling. Whatever sports equipment you need, you have more fun with Voight. Dick?
Senators, you're ready. Frank Howard, Ted Williams, and Denny McLain are challengers. The Boston Celtics, I know you're itching to go. Havlicek, Auerbach, and Russell. And our first category will be record breakers and a fielding play that saved the World Series right after this Sports Challenge timeout. There it is.
You're watching Classic Sports Network. You're in a nightmare filled with monsters that fight, that crawl, that kill. Welcome to Predators of the Wild, an intense journey through a real-life chamber of horrors from Time Life Video. Face creatures so fearsome only the brave dare get close enough to film them. Seem so close, they will make your skin crawl. Call this toll-free number now and begin your journey to the shadow world with Giant Tarantula, yours for just $9.99. Confront a spider that measures a foot across and has venom so powerful it dissolves its victims from the inside out. Other videos take you deeper into the shadow world. Get Giant Tarantula for just $9.99. Keep only the tapes you want. There's never a commitment to buy. So call now and stare into the eyes of a monster.
To order Predators, call 1-800-297-4411. That's 1-800-297-4411. Or send $9.99 plus $3.49 shipping and handling to Predators, P.O. Box 2727, Department CSN, Costa Mesa, California.
Mariners versus Yankees. It was the game of the year.
Oh, hang on to the roof!
An instant classic.
Put the mustard on her, baby!
Catch Game 2 of the 95 American League Division Series, Tuesday at 6 Eastern, only on Classic Sports Network.
The Boston Celtics, Washington Senators, our teams on Sports Challenge, ready the first category, record breakers, the toss-up. Record-setting Yankees of 1952 and their seven-game series with the Dodgers. If the Yanks win, it's a new record of six straight for the American League. Now the seventh game, Yanks lead 4-2, bottom of the seventh. The Dodgers are threatening. They have the bases filled with two outs.
Jackie Robinson up, bases loaded for Brooklyn, seventh inning, 4-2 Yankees. Brillo at third, Cox at second, Reese at first, they lead away. Bob Cassava delivers, Robinson swings, and sends a high pop fly in the infield. Collins doesn't come in from first, here's Billy Martin.
Stop the film, the Washington Senators, Ted Williams, your answer please.
Billy Martin coming in on a pop fly.
That would be correct, but it's not the correct answer to the question we have. It was Billy Martin who made that great catch. Can't be too quick on the trigger. I'll tell you what, the manager of the Senators still has those great reflexes, that hand-eye coordination. All right, we'll see the rest of that film. We won't. You saw, I think, most of it. You saw Billy Martin make that great catch. The Yankees manager at the time was Casey Stengel, Boston, who later managed the amazing Mets. For 20 points, your toss-up question, name another major league team managed by Casey Stengel. You have 5 seconds.
St. Louis.
St. Louis is incorrect. So we will not give the toss-up to either team. We'll go on to the free throws. The answer, I think Ted Williams knew the answer. Did you, Ted, know the answer?
Braves.
Braves and the Dodgers, Casey Stengel managed. So we will play the two free throws as toss-up questions, all right? Be on the alert. First one there gets the chance to answer. Record breakers, the category. A record breaker hockey's Frank Mahovlich of the Montreal Canadiens. The Canadiens, underdogs against the Blackhawks in the 71 Stanley Cup Finals, were led by Mahovlich. 14 goals broke Phil Esposito's record of 13.
Mahovlich shoots, deflected by Esposito. Mahovlich, after the rebound, gets it, scores! Frank Mahovlich has scored 14 goals in the playoffs, a new Stanley Cup record.
For 10 points, on that same Montreal Stanley Cup championship team, Frank Mahovlich has a brother. What is his name? Boston Celtics. Your answer, please.
Pete Mahovlich.
Pete Mahovlich is correct for 10 points. 10-0, the Celtics lead. All right, remember, Washington, this second free throw is also the same as a toss-up. You're alive. Record breaker in his rookie professional football year with the Chicago Bears, Gale Sayers. He set an NFL mark in 1965, scoring 22 touchdowns as a first-year man.
Tommy Davis fighting the mud here at Wrigley Field, Chicago, gets his kick away. Gale Sayers has it at the 15. Sidelines, breaks a tackle, gets a block. He's to the 25, the 30, comes to the inside, 35, he's to the 40, and Gale Sayers is going to gallop for a score. 85 yards for a touchdown for Gale Sayers, his sixth of the day.
Gale Sayers shares the record of 6 touchdowns in a single game for 10 points, Boston or Washington. What former NFL star holds the record for Washington Senators, Denny McLain? No, or who was Preston Howard?
Frank Lenny Howard. Moore, the Baltimore Colts.
Lenny Moore is not the answer to our question.
Wait a minute.
For 10 points, Boston Celtics, it's your chance to answer now.
Well, he guessed Pete Mahovlich wasn't this part of
No, that was, remember, oh. We all missed the toss-up and the free throws are being handled. Well, that Auerbach never loses that feeling for running the ball club. All right, Red. This one belongs to you now. The Senators jumped the gun. For 10 points, what former NFL star holds the record for most touchdowns lifetime with 126? The all-time NFL touchdown maker lifetime. You have 5 seconds. Your answer, please.
Jimmy Brown.
Jimmy Brown. You just beat the bell. That is correct for 10 points. So after the first round, the Celtics 20, the Washington Senators nothing. Your category now, men, unforgettable moments in sports. This is a toss-up. The moment will not be forgotten by New York fans. May 8th, 1970, seventh game, the NBA championship, Madison Square Garden, the Lakers and the Knicks.
25 years of frustration coming to an end here at the Garden in New York, led by their limping center, Willis Reed. The Knicks have a big lead. Final seconds, Dick Barnett. Fall back, baby! 113-99, the Knicks celebrate their first ever NBA title, and the fans chant,
the Knicks failed to repeat their championship a year later. Listen carefully. Your toss-up question for 20 points. In 1971, which team eliminated the Knicks in the Boston Celtics? The answer, please.
Baltimore Bullets.
Baltimore Bullets is correct. They eliminated the Knicks in the semifinal round. You get the 2 free throws, Boston. Unforgettable moments in sports, this one. We'll take us back to the year 1930. Remember John Havlicek? Amidst an era still golden in sports. Throughout the world, Mr. Golf was the name of the great Bobby Jones of Atlanta, Georgia, USA.
At St. Andrews, Bobby Jones stands at the edge of the green and at the edge of greatness. With putts like this, he won the British Amateur and the British Open. At Interlaken, another long putt. The first ever to break par for 72 holes in the Open. Three legs on the crown. Then in the U.S. Amateur, Jones defeated Gene Holman's 8-7 with great approach shots like this one. Beautiful. The Grand Slam, the four biggest tournaments to one great golfer, Bobby Jones.
Since his retirement, Boston, Bobby Jones has been the guiding power behind one of the world's great annual golf tournaments for 10 points. Name that tournament. 5 seconds.
The Greater Greensboro Open.
That is incorrect. It is not the Greater Greensboro Open. For 20 points, we double the point total. If Washington can give me the answer of the tournament that Bobby Jones has been the guiding power behind. Your answer?
The Masters.
The Masters is correct for 20 points. The score now reads Boston 40. The Ted Williams guided Washington Senators 20. The category is unforgettable moments, and this is your free throw, Boston. An unforgettable moment in 1955 as we go to the baseball All-Star game.
A 5-5 tie, bottom of the 12th inning, County Stadium in Milwaukee. On the mound for the American League, right-hander Frank Sullivan from the Boston Red Sox. His pitch to Stan Musial is hit well, and Musial makes it gone. K-line back to the fence, watches that go in the bleachers.
Boston for 10 points. When Stan Musial first broke into organized baseball, what position did he play? 5 seconds.
Pitcher.
Pitcher is correct for 10 points. And after two rounds on Sports Challenge, the Boston Celtics 50, the Washington Senators 20, and we'll be back with nicknames in sports and a look at a 104-yard touchdown right after this Sports Challenge timeout.
Hi there, everybody. I'm Mark Scott saying, welcome to Home Run Derby.
Play ball!
It's a home run or nothing here on Home Run Derby. If it's in the strike zone, you'd better swing at it.
Fight!
In my day.
Well, keep on swinging. That's the game.
Fellas, today you're going for the big money.
Holy Toledo! Man, he belted that ball. So long until tomorrow.
Hank, you're making a career out of Home Run Derby.
Fire up!
Home Run Derby swings for the fences every Sunday on Classic Sports.
Golfers, here's an opportunity of a lifetime to play with the same driving iron that PGA professional Mike Smith used to drive a ball a world record 335 yards from the fairway. But that's not all. This amazing club automatically corrects hooks and slices. The controller's explosive power comes from its oversized head. Its uncanny accuracy comes from a patented curve across its hitting surface that automatically reduces the abnormal spin caused by off-center shots. Ordinary irons will hook or slice off-center shots into the rough. The controller keeps them on the fairway. No other iron can do that.
Finally, I can murder the ball without losing it.
What an amazing club. I've cut 6 strokes.
We know that if you hit the controller 3 or 4 times, you'll never play with a fairway wood again. You must hit longer and straighter and cut at least 5 strokes instantly or your money back. Call the number on your screen now and cut 5 or more strokes, guaranteed.
Do you know you might be spending double what you need to for your life insurance? Have a pencil ready. In a moment, I'll give you a toll-free number you can call to find out. American Republic Insurance Company has a breakthrough buying system for purchasing low-cost, high-quality term life insurance. By using an 800 number, you now buy direct from the company. These are policies that can also save you hundreds of dollars a year. Want proof? $30 a month, just a dollar a day, buys $369,000 of coverage for a man age 35. Also, for a dollar a day, a woman age 35 can buy $430,000 of coverage. And these rates are guaranteed level for 10 years. Get your free no-obligation custom quote and full information. Call the company direct at 1-800-890-0096. American Republic, the direct-to-you way to buy the most term life insurance at a truly low cost. Stop overspending. Call this toll-free number today. 1-800-890-0096.
You're watching Classic Sports Network.
On Sports Challenge, the score at the halfway mark, the Boston Celtics 50, the Washington Senators 20.
Ready, men, here's our toss-up question. The category is nicknames, and our first subject has such great speed that he's been called many names, especially by would-be tacklers. He's Travis Williams of the Rams. Now, let's watch him in 1967 against the Rams when Williams was a Green Bay Packer.
The Belgian boomer, Bruce Gossett, approaches the ball. Here's his kick deep into the end zone. Travis Williams, the roadrunner, waits for the Green Bay Packers. 4 yards deep. He's going to take it out. He's to the five, to the nine. Oh, as he hit at the nine, but spins away, and he's running for daylight. He's to the 15, gets the block, to the 20, gets another block at the 30, and Williams is on his way. Travis Williams, 104 yards for a touchdown.
Travis Williams has the nickname the Roadrunner. The question for 20 points, your toss-up. What National League Baseball outfielder also is known? The Washington Senators. Ralph Garr is correct of the Atlanta Braves. Bill, you know that one as well. Bill Russell was just beaten by the quick work of Frank Howard. Ralph Garr, the rookie for the Braves, known as the Roadrunner, that gives the Celtics a 50-40 lead, but two free throws go to the Senators. Category nicknames. Famous nickname involved with this action as we see the most important hockey goal of the 1970-71 NHL season. Final game of the Stanley Cup.
Trailing the Chicago Blackhawks 2-0, Montreal in red has gained a 2-2 tie on a goal by Henri Richard. The team that wins this game wins the Stanley Cup. A long pass to Richard on the fly. Around Magnuson, shoots, scores! Great goal to Henri Richard, puts Montreal in front, 3-2.
That goal ended the scoring with Henri Richard, a hero, as Montreal won the Stanley Cup. Henri's older brother is the famous Maurice the Rocket Richard. For 10 points, what is Henri Richard's nickname?
Pocket Rocket.
Pocket Rocket is correct. Frank Howard up on his hockey. The game is tied. A 50-50 tie. Free throw belongs to the Washington Senators. Here's a baseball nickname in action. Final moment of the 1950 World Series. The Phillies trail 3-0, trying to keep it alive in the ninth inning of Game 4. They trail the Yanks 5-2, but they're rallying against rookie Whitey Ford. Casey Stengel has gone to the bullpen for a starting pitcher to close the door.
Big Yankee right-hander fires a strike. He sets, check second, the pitch. Check swing, strike two. The Phillies down to their final strike. Here it comes. Lovato swing, strike three. The Yankees have swept the Whiz Kids four straight here in the 50 World Series.
For 10 points, the free throw to Washington, the pitcher whom you just saw, is one of only four pitchers in Major League history to ever throw two no-hitters in a single season. For 10 points, what is his name? Got 5 seconds.
Reynolds.
Allie Reynolds is correct of the New York Yankees. In case you're wondering and might be guessing someone else, the other three, Jim Maloney, then with Cincinnati, Virgil Trucks of the Tigers, and of course Johnny Vandermeer, who threw the back-to-back no-hitters with Cincinnati. The score after three rounds, Washington 60, Boston 50, another great game, and we go to our final category, long shots. Here's your toss-up. Unexpected strong performances by underdogs. I guess we'd have to start with the Mets. Never higher than ninth in any previous year. They won the 1969 pennant as incredible long shots and were given little chance in the series against highly favored Baltimore. In Game 4, the Mets lead 1-0 in the ninth inning, but the Orioles are threatening with men on first and third and only one out.
Seaver sets the pitch. Robinson swings a line drive, base hit to right center field.
Ron Swoboda with that catch. The Mets went on into the 10th inning and won the game and won the series. Not known for his defensive prowess, Swoboda saved the game with a marvelous catch. Another former Met, also not known for his defense, carried the nickname Marvelous. The question is, who is that marvelous Met? The Boston Celtics there first.
Marvelous Marv Thornberry.
That is correct for 20 points. Marvelous Marv Thornberry. And the Celtics take the lead 70-60. And it's your free throw, Boston. A long shot in golf. Lee Trevino, a 28-year-old unknown in 1968, until he took part in the Oak Hill course in Rochester, New York. He took it apart. It was the U.S. Open. And Trevino suddenly developed quite a following.
Lee Trevino, the surprise leader. Trevino has a big lead over Yancey, and now on 18, he must sink this putt to become the first ever to stay under 70 on all four rounds. He does it. Lee Trevino wins the Open with 275. That ties the Open record set just a year ago.
For 10 points, Boston. One of these golfing immortals never won a U.S. Open. For 10 points, was it Hogan, Nicklaus, Palmer, or Sanders? For 10 points, you have 5 seconds.
Palmer
is incorrect, so we double the point total for 20 points and a chance to take the lead. Which of the following did not win the U.S. Open? Washington, Hogan, Nicklaus, Palmer, or Sanders? You have 5 seconds.
Sanders
is correct, and Washington regains the lead, 80 to 70. Our final free throw category long shot that belongs to the Celtics. Another long shot. The great light heavyweight champion, Billy Kahn, meets champion Joe Louis, 1941, New York City. Kahn is on his way to the heavyweight title, or is he? Let's go to round 13.
The surprising Kahn on the right has piled up an early lead with his clever boxing, and now in the 13th, the kid from Pittsburgh is elected to slug it out with a champion. And he lands with left and right hands. Kahn with a big rally in 13. He's trying to put Louis away. The champion, the brown bomber, bearing in, however, looking for that one big blow. You got to watch the right hand, and there it is. A good right hand to the jaw, followed by a left hook to the body, a left and a right, a good right hand, and Kahn is written down. Kahn is down in 13. Will he make it in 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10? No, he did not make it. Kahn did not make it. Joe Louis has knocked out Billy Kahn in the 13th round. He retains his heavyweight title.
Prior to that fight with Kahn, Louis had successfully defended his world heavyweight title 17 times. The question for 10 points, Boston, and a chance to tie our own sports challenge game. Louis won 25 straight fights. The great Joe Louis held his title longer than any heavyweight champion in history. For 10 points, did he hold it 6, 8, 10, or 12 years? You have 5 seconds. Your answer, please.
12 years.
12 years is correct. Joe Louis held the title from 1935 to 1947. So the score after 4 complete rounds, the Celtics 80, the Senators 80. And in a moment, our bonus biography round worth up to 90 points and an in-person visit with this superstar after this sports challenge timeout.
Vice Junior serving, drives to the basket, goes up and...
You're watching Classic Sports Network, where the legends play.
She's a lady. Oh, 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 she's a lady.
AM Gold, all of your favorite hits of the 60s and 70s in one fantastic collection.
The sailors say, Brandy, you're a fine girl. What a good wife you would be.
Get AM Gold for just $9.99 on compact disc or double length cassette. That's 22 fabulous hits.
Sweet, sweet city woman. Just an old-fashioned love song. Cherokee people, Cherokee tribe. Side to side.
Then audition other great AM Gold albums. There's no minimum to buy. Cancel anytime.
I think I love you, so what am I so?
Call now. To order AM Gold 1971, call 1-800-293-3900. Call now. Or send $9.99 plus $3.50 shipping and handling to this address.
When I made a guarantee that we'd win Super Bowl III, it wasn't conjured up. I didn't give it much thought before the game. But I was at the Miami Touchdown Club to receive an award of AFL Player of the Year, and I got up to the podium to speak, and a guy in the back of the room says, "Hey, Namath, we're going to kick your, you know?" And I said, "Whoa, wait a minute, man. Look, it's my turn to talk. I'm up here at the podium, and I got news for you. For the last couple of weeks, you guys have been talking about how bad Baltimore is going to beat it. Well, I got news for you. We're going to win the game. I guarantee it." Now, I didn't, you know, it wasn't a plan. It was an honest feeling. And we just believed in ourselves. We really believed in ourselves getting it done. Watch NFL Night at the Classics, Wednesday at 8 on Classic Sports Network.
You're watching Classic Sports Network.
A great game. I believe the first time we've ever had a sports challenge tie going into the mystery guest. The Boston Celtics, the champions, 80. The challengers, the Washington Senators, 80. And now it's time for our bonus biography. Okay, Johnny, go.
This world champion was born in Lexington, Alabama, but he grew up in Detroit, where he first began...
Stop, the Boston Celtics were there.
Joe Louis.
Joe Louis is correct, and the Celtics have won again. The Brown Bomber, Joe Louis, and ladies and gentlemen, here's one of the great fighters of all time. Joe Russell, Russell is the name of Justin. Joe, I'm wondering, there's that great quote... As a champion, you said one time that they can run, but they can't hide. At what fight did you say
that? Just on television. The Billy Conn first fight.
And he was ahead on points at that time.
That's right, he was.
Joe, of all the men...
Something like, okay, we hit that home run in Detroit that time, an All-Star game, remember?
Did you happen to see that one?
Yeah, I was sitting right there watching it.
Joe, of all the men you faced, and as a champion that held his crown longest of all, a heavyweight champion... Who would you consider now the toughest man you ever faced?
Uncle Sam.
That's wonderful. He's handled all of us. I know they want to meet you. The great Joe Louis, the greatest heavyweight champion of all. Well, our champions are the Boston Celtics again. The fans in a moment, Johnny Gilbert will tell you all about our winners and about next week's challengers. But first, we pause for this sports challenge timeout.
This famous sports figure will be the subject of our bonus biography round on The Sports Challenge.
This is our one question category on the classics in sports.
Here we go with the clues.
Classic. Classic.
When a player knows the answer, he should press his button to sound his buzzer. Would you like to try again? All right, time is up. The answer, classic sports.
Catch Sports Challenge Sunday only on Classic Sports Network.
Feeling stressed out? Is that nagging back pain acting up again? Now you can experience a complete and relaxed...